S&S Engineering, the moving force in gentle part handling. S&S Engineering manufactures gentle part feeding equipment in three basic configurations: conveyors, accumulators, and feeder orienters. All three can be combined to produce a custom engineered system. Unidirectional polypropylene brush line material mounted to an isolated, vibrating surface replaces conventional belts and rollers, thus eliminating pinch points and providing greater safety for both the operator and the parts. The brush line mat provides a soft medium for the conveyance of even the most sensitive parts. The speed is controlled by the amplitude of the vibration and is easily regulated to accommodate a wide variety of gentle part feeding applications. Some of the product features include gentle, non-abrasive conveying surface, hook and loop backed fastening system for convenient removal of brush material for cleaning and replacement purposes, quiet operation, minimum space requirements, high feed pressure to push parts across a dead plate or work rest, directional change without the use of hard diverters, recirculation and accumulation of parts, low maintenance, and minimum power consumption. Brushed vibratory conveyors are the backbone of our gentle parts feeding system. Used alone or in conjunction with other equipment, the modular design allows easy and flexible grouping. V-track conveyors are ideal for cylindrical parts. The dual surface contact increases feed pressure and also maintains alignment. Units can be built in single or multi-lane arrangements. Ideal for centerless grinding applications, providing high feed pressures as parts are pushed across the work rest. Overhead guides are optional for containment of unstable parts. Brush plates can be uniquely made to accommodate the shape of the part. For example, light bulbs are fed using a head-hanging style conveyor, taking advantage of the part's weight bias. Bulbs are delivered to an assembly or test and packaging operation. Other custom brush plate shapes include a center relief area to accommodate a protruding hub. Twist track style brush plates gradually twist and turn a part's orientation. Parts can be delivered up to any angle up to 180 degrees. Conveyor features include modular design, which permits flexible grouping options, table mounted to an existing frame, floor mounted with adjustable legs, portable with the use of locking casters, fine height adjustment using a screw jack arrangement, square interface to existing equipment, no pulley radius issues, parts gently transfer 90 degrees without hard diverters by utilizing bias brush, rapid adjust side liners to quickly accommodate a range of part sizes. An accumulator is two or more conveyors grouped side by side to create part recirculation. Bias brushing techniques allow parts to turn 90 degrees at the end of each conveyor section. A typical accumulator application would receive parts online from a manufacturing operation or bulk storage device. Parts then recirculate in single layer form, creating a gentle handling buffer area. Operators or robots can then unload parts without concern to part damage. Accumulators can be used as vision-guided feeders. Parts are presented in random orientation to a vision-guided robot's field of view. After programming the camera to the part shape, the robot will decide which parts are ready for picking. The wrist action of the robot can select parts in the full 360-degree spectrum. Dual feeders are used for higher feed rates. One side remains stationary for picking while the other side circulates. Total isolation ensures that no transmission of vibration is sent from one side to another. Brushed vibratory feeder orienters are similar to an accumulator. Parts are recirculated in random orientation and eventually delivered single file. However, the difference is a tooling area is employed to both direct and accept properly oriented parts. In addition, tooling will redirect or reject improperly oriented parts. Tooling can be either mechanical or pneumatic in nature. Additionally, tooling can also be in conjunction with fiber optic or a variety of image sensing devices. Come on over, baby.
Yes, I say, come on over, baby. Baby, you can't go wrong. We ain't faking it. Oh, Lord, I can't get going on. Well, I say, come on over, baby. We got chicken in the morning. I said, shake, baby, shake. I said, shake it, baby, shake it. I said, shake, baby, shake. Come on over.
Accumulators can also discharge parts similar to a feeder orienter. Here, aluminum slugs are hand-loaded to the accumulator table that eventually directs parts single file to a discharge conveyor. Parts are presented one at a time for the next manufacturing operation. The bearing industry defines a square roller to be a cylindrical part with a diameter equal to its length. S&S Engineering manufactures a tube-tooled feeder to deliver square rollers with the center line horizontal, touching end-to-end, in a continuous stream for centerless grinding. A unique clamp arrangement allows for a fast and convenient method of changing tooling for various part sizes. Some parts generate a great deal of noise in conventional feeding equipment, such as steel vibratory bowls. Steel water pump impellers are shown in this application. Parts are loaded into a hopper, while the twist-track tool feeder system gently and quietly delivers parts to an assembly operation in the proper orientation. No sound enclosure was required, which reduces cost and allows free access to the feeder. Another version of a vision-guided feeder uses three conveying zones: a wide recirculation area, zone 1, on the right, a narrower feed section, zone 2, that presents parts single file, end-to-end. The third zone runs slightly faster to create part separation. In addition, zone 3 permits a wide variety of tooling options that are easily interchanged. A vision-guided robot evaluates parts as they travel along zone 3 and picks properly oriented parts. Unrecognizable parts continue through the system and re-enter the process. All systems are equipped with a NEMA 12 oil-tight enclosure. Machines are also wired to Machine Tools JIC electrical standards. 115 or 230 volt single-phase power is required for the drive units. As an option, Allen Bradley PLCs are available for systems requiring additional electrical logic circuits. To ensure high quality and timely deliveries, all products are designed and manufactured on location. Every system that S&S designs is unique to the particular needs, present and future of the client. All components are designed in a modular fashion in order to interface better with other machinery and to fight obsolescence. Additional products can be integrated into the S&S line of conveyors, accumulators, and feeder orienters, such as pick and place units, robots, vision products, and bulk storage devices. Our services include an on-site evaluation of your parts handling needs and also involves custom system design consultation, installation, tuning, and maintenance.